Today, we are going to experiment and connect with the different parts of our body. We are going to imagine that we have strings attached to different parts of our body that move us. So, someone is pulling one string and is moving this particular part of our body, and the rest of our body follows, or it doesn't follow, depending on the movement. So, in order to start, let's stand up. Stand up with me. Have your legs a little bit open so that you have more balance and stability. And let's start by imagining that we have one string attached to our right hand. So at this part of our hand. Let's imagine we have one string here and someone is pulling it up. If you want to help you, you can have your other hand touching your right hand and imagine that you're really pulling it. Maybe this will help you understand the movement better. So, imagine that someone is pulling this string up and then down and then to your right and to your left and maybe in circles and in your diagonals. And imagine that this movement can be big and slow, or it can be small, it can be fast, or it can be small and repetitive and slow, or big and fast. Whatever you want. So you want to play with that and experiment. And whenever you want to play more with one movement and with one part of your body, you can press pause on the video and continue as much as you want and then come back to the video and continue with me. So then we're going to go to our right elbow. Again, we're going to imagine we have a string attached here and someone is moving it. So let's imagine first that it's moving it up. And then down, and then right and left, and in circles. And again, let's imagine that this movement can be big, or very small, or fast, or slow. Good. And are you ready to go to our right elbow? Let's imagine we have a string attached here and someone is moving it, is pulling it up and then down and then to my left and to my right and in circles and forward, front and back and in the diagonals. So the movement can become bigger or smaller. It can become fast. Or very slow, and observe how the other part of your body and the rest of your body is moving as well because of the movement of your shoulder. And you see that if you do a big movement, the rest of your body is moving more. And if you have a small movement, maybe the rest of your body almost is not moving at all. So let's go to the other hand and the other arm. Starting by our left hand, this part right here. Again, you can help with your right hand. And let's imagine we have a string attached here. Are you ready to move it? Let's start. How you can move it? You can move it, as we said, up and down and to your sides and in diagonal and front and back if you have space and then in circles. And you can see if you can move it slow or fast, or you can make very small movements or big ones that affect the rest of your body more. So play with it, experiment with it, and then go to your left elbow. Imagine you have a string attached here and see how you can move it. You can move it up, on your side, down, on your side again, up. Down, play with it. You don't have to follow what I'm doing exactly. Do what you feel you want to do right now. You might want to do it slow or fast, or do the same movement again and again, or change, go front, back, observe how the rest of your body is moving, and then go to your left shoulder, and let's start moving it with a string attached here. So we move it up, down, to our sides, in circles, front, back. We make long, big movements or small, fast ones, however you want. Nice. And now that we have moved our arms and hands, let's move to our legs. So we will start with our right leg and right foot. And we are going to imagine that we have a string attached here. So someone is pulling this string and is moving our leg up or down, or to our sides, or in circles, front, back. You can do whatever you want, as we did before. You can make a very small movement, or a very large one. And it's okay if you lose your balance. If you want to have more balance, you can bend a little bit more the other knee. So here, the left knee. And you can move up, down. Again, observe how the rest of your body is moving with the movement of your feet. And now we're going to imagine that we have a string attached to our right knee. So again, if it helps you, you can put your hand on your knee and imagine that you're really pulling. And if you're wearing trousers or pants, you can really pull, you can actually pull the fabric to help you. So imagine you have a string attached to your right knee and start moving it up and down and to your sides and in circle. You can make the movement big or small, front, back. You can make it very slow or fast. Good, and let's move to the other leg to do the exact same thing. So first we're going to the left foot and we imagine we have a string attached here, and this string is moving us up, down, to our sides, in circles, in our diagonals. It makes a big movement or a very small one, slow one, fast one. And then we go to our left knee and we imagine we have a string attached here and is pulling us up or down or to our sides, back, front. Is making big movements and slow ones, or very small. It's making fast and big movements, or slow and small ones. Good. And again, as I said before, if you want to stay more moving one part of your body, you can press pause. Keep doing that and then come back to the video. So let's go to the final part of our body. We're going to imagine that we have a string attached to the crown of our head, to the top of our head. So here, if you want help with that, you can put, again, you can place your hand here and in order to understand better which is the part that is moving. So imagine that you have a string attached here and this string is pulling you up. Let's bring it down to your sides, in circles, front, back, to the diagonals. Again, you can make a very big movement or a small one, but it's barely a movement. You can make a fast movement, but be careful with your head, with your fast movements, because it can get a little bit, you can get dizzy, or a slow one. Good. And now imagine that you have different strings attached to your whole body. So we did these parts of our body, our hands, our elbows, our shoulders, our feet, our knees, and our head. So imagine that you have strings attached to these different parts of your body and they are moving you at the same time. So you can imagine that you are moving by your hand and then your knee and then your head, and at the same time maybe an elbow and the foot and the head again, the shoulder. So play with it, experiment with it. You can stay, as I said before, at one part of your body more if you like it and you want to experiment with it. Maybe it is your left shoulder that draws your attention and you want to play with it more. Your head, your knee, whatever you want. You can also put some type of music that you really like, that it helps you with this movement. It can be very rhythmical or very melodical. And experiment with it, see how you can move in the music with this type of movements. And I hope that this activity helped you connect with your body in a different way, with these different parts of your body, helped you observe how it is to move. To start my movement by my elbow, by my elbow, by my shoulder, or by my knee, my foot. I don't know about you, but I don't start my movements very often by these parts of my body, and I don't pay attention to it as well. So I hope that it really helped you to connect with your body. I hope that it was fun for you, that you enjoyed playing with it, and that you're going to continue with it and repeat it. And this is the end of today's video. Thank you very much for being with me.